Let's start by creating an Android application. I'm going to start new Android project, choose empty activity and give the application name. I'm going to name it as camera and gallery. And I'm going to choose the language as Java, and the minimum API level should be 23. So it's okay if you want to use the minimum API level less than Marshmallow, but we need to ask the camera permission here, and it is really easy to ask for the runtime permissions in the API level 23 and above. Click on finish. Okay, the app is ready now, and first I'm going to design the layout that we are going to need for this application. This app will have a very simple layout, so we'll use one image view to display the image that is selected from the camera or from the gallery. And let me use the placeholder for the image. This is the simple layout that we are going to use for this application. Here you can see we have the camera button, gallery button and one image view. And if I click on this, you can see I have given the ID for the both image image view and the buttons. So for camera buttons, I have given camera button as ID. For gallery, I have given gallery button. And for the image view, I have given the display image view as ID. Here you can see all the source code. If you want the source code, then you can download this from the GitHub that I will provide the link in the description. So let's go with the application. Now in the main activity, I'm going to select all these buttons and image. First, I'll create the variables that we need. So we need one image view variable. I'll import the variable and give the name as selected image. Okay, we have two buttons. One is for camera and another one is for gallery. Okay. Now I'll select the XML resources that we have specified in activity main. So I can do that by using the same variable that I have created above. So selected image, find viewer ID, r.id and the ID of the resources, display image view. I'll select the XML resources for both the button that we have here. First, we are going to select the image from the camera. So we are going to open the camera and let the user take the picture, and we are going to display that picture in the image view that we have given in the layout. So to do that, I'm going to specify the onClick listener on the camera button. So camera button dot set onClick listener, new onClick listener. So this onClick listener will be triggered when the camera button is clicked. So for a starter, I'm just going to display the message that says the camera button is clicked. So let me create new toast, and message will say that camera button is clicked. I'm going to implement onClick listener on the gallery button as well. So gallery button dot set onClick listener will create the new onClick listener, and I will just display the same message here. So let me copy this toast message from here and paste it in the onClick method of gallery button. And instead of camera button, I will display that gallery button is clicked. So for a starter, let's just run this app and see the buttons are working correctly or not. So I have connected my device here. So my phone is already connected. So I'm going to run this app. If you have the emulator, you can run this in your emulator. Okay, so this is the general layout that I have created. So we have this camera and gallery button. So if I click on one of these buttons, it will display the toast message that I just set on the onClick method. So if I click on gallery, it displayed the gallery button is clicked message. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is we are going to open the camera whenever the camera button is clicked. And to do that, we need to ask the camera permission from the user. Now let's go to the Android manifest file here and add the camera permission. So we are going to let the Android OS knows that this application is going to need the camera permissions from the user. So after that, let's go back to the main activity, and here whenever the camera button is clicked, we will try to open the camera and let the user click the image. But as I said, we need to ask for the permission in runtime, so I'm gonna do that first. So I will create one method, and inside that I'm going to ask for the user to give the permission of the camera. And if user do not give the permission, we will display some message that says the camera permission is required. And if the permission is granted after the after requesting that permission, then we will just open the camera intent and let the user click the image. Okay, I will create one method that is ask camera permission. Okay, now let me click on this red ball here and create the method inside the main activity. Before asking the permission from the user, we need to check if the permission is already given to the app. If the permission is not given, we will request the permission from the user in runtime. And if the permission is given, then we will start the whatever the activity that we need to do after the permission is granted. So I'm gonna write few block of code that will check if the permission is already given to the application or not. By using the check self permission method of context compat, we can check if the permission is already given to the application or not. Inside the if condition, I'm gonna check that if context compat dot check self permission, and inside this we need to pass few parameters like context and the permission that we want to check, that is in our case is camera. So manifest.permission.camera, and we will verify that if it is equals to not equals to package manager dot permission granted. So permission granted is an integer code. If the check self permission will return some code, and that code is equals to the package manager dot permission granted, that means that user have already given the required permission to our application. If that is not equals, then we need to request for the permission on runtime. So we can request that by activity compat class, and inside that we have this request permissions method, and we will need to pass few parameters like this and permission that we want from the user. So that we need to pass inside the string array manifest.permission.camera. And we need to pass one more thing, that is the request code, and that is used to identify the particular permissions. I'm gonna give request code as 101. You can give any integer number, and for simplicity I'm gonna convert this to one constant variable. So I can do that by selecting the digit, and by holding Ctrl Alt and C, I can convert that to the static final constant variable. And I'm gonna change that to camera permission code. So camera perm code, and hit enter, and it will create that variable for you. In another case, if the permission is already granted, we are going to open the camera, right? So open camera activity that we need to implement in the future. But for now, if the user denied the request for the camera permission, then we need to show something to the user that might say that camera permission is required to use this app or something like that. So to do that, we need to override the method called permission on permission result. Okay, on request permission result. And here it will give you the request code for the particular permission that is denied. And it also gives the permissions if we have multiple permissions, and it also gives the grant results result code. And if we have multiple permissions, then it is going to have the multiple result code. So that's why it is in array format. So let me delete this. And inside this, I'm going to check if the permission is granted for the camera or not. Okay, so that's why I'm gonna use the request code of the camera and compare with the request code that is passed to this on request permission result. So request code is equals to camera permission code. If that is equal, then I'm going to check if the grant results array is empty or it do have some data or not. So grant result dot length is less than 0, that means it is empty. If the grant result is 0, that means the permission is not granted. And I'll also check if the grant results is equals to the permission granted code or not. So if this condition, if this both condition is true, that means the user have given the permission to use the camera. So now we can start the open camera activity and we can start clicking the images. But if this both condition is false, that means the user have denied the request, right? So in that case, I will just display one toast that inform the user that we need the camera permission to use this particular application. So now we don't have this open camera method implemented yet. So I'm going to implement that. I'm going to create this method. And for now, I'm just going to display that camera open request. Okay. But in the later in the video, we will implement the camera open intent activity. So if grant result.length is less than 0, it says that it is always false. So let me just make this other way around. That is, let me make this greater than 0. So its length should be greater than 0. Okay. So that means if the length is greater than 0, that means we have something, some value on the grant results array. So now I will run this app and see how this implementation is going and if the permission is working properly or not. Okay, now we have these two options here. I have not implemented the gallery, but if I click on camera button here, it will ask for the request from the user. So it is asking for me to give permission to this particular app to take the picture and the record video. So now if I click on deny, then it will display this message that I have given here. So camera permission is required to use the camera. Okay, but if I give the permission, if I allow this permission and grant the permission to use the camera, then it should display this whatever the toast message that I have given inside this open camera method for now. Okay, it says camera open request. Okay, so this is working correctly. Now we will implement this open camera method inside this. So I can start the camera intent, the default camera app that we have in our Android application, by using the new, by creating the new intent. So I'm going to create new camera intent here and new intent. And inside this, I need to pass the specific request for the Android operating system to open the default camera app. So I can do that by using the media store class, which handle the all the media related stuff in Android OS. Okay, so media store dot action image capture. So this is the specific request that we are passing to the this intent, and whenever this intent is called, it is going to open the camera. I need to start this activity. Instead of just starting the activity, we are going to start the activity with result. So start activity with result or for result. Okay, so this one, and inside this we need to pass the intent and we need to pass one request code as well. So just like how we have passed the request code in camera permission here, just like that we need to pass this request code to identify the particular request that made by the user or made by the application. So I will pass the user request code as 102 and I'm gonna create the same thing constant variable for this request code as well. So Control Alt C and I will name it as camera request code and click on enter and it will create the constant here. Okay. Okay, the app is running and if I click on camera, it will open the camera intent. Okay. So you can see my ceiling and my fan. And this is the camera intent. Okay, and if I move it, you can see like that. Okay, and if I click on this capture, it will have the option to save or discard this image. But if I save this image right now, it will do nothing because we have not implemented that part, and I can discard as well. Okay, so I can click on anything and it will go back to our main activity. So to save that image and display that image in the image view, we need to implement the start activity result method here. So on activity result, and it's going to pass the result code, request code, and the data. Okay, so this data will have the image data that we need to, we can capture and display in the image view. For now, I'm just going to check if the the past request is camera request or not. So I can do that by simply comparing the request code with the camera request code that I have. And inside this, if this is the camera request, then I'm going to display the image. I'm going to get the image from the data and display that image. So to save the data in the gallery and get the absolute URL of the image that we have just clicked in the camera, we need to implement few other methods that is more complex. So we will do that in the next video or in the next part. But for now, I'm just going to get a thumbnail of the image that we have just clicked and display that. So that thumbnail is already come with this data that is passed through this onActivityResult method. So to do that, I'll just create one bitmap and I will name it as image, and I'm gonna use the data.getExtras.get, and I'm going to get the data that is passed through this activity result method, and we need to cast this to the bitmap. So let me click on this ball and cast this to bitmap. Now I can use the image view that we have. So selected image dot set bitmap, and I'm gonna set the image as a bitmap. Okay, so this should capture the image and set the image as our background for the image view. So let me run the app. Okay, now if I click on camera, it will start the camera, and now I'm going to capture the image. And now if I save this image, it should be displayed in the image view that we have here. Okay, so just like this, we have now opened the camera intent and captured the image and displayed that here. So this video is already getting too long, so I'm going to make the another part of this video. So in the next part, we will learn how to save that image in the gallery and how to get the absolute URL so that that particular URL can be used to upload this image to the Firebase. And we'll also learn how to select the image from the gallery and upload that to the Firebase.